Hola. As counting begins and we wait for the results to trickle in, the results that will tell us who will be ruling India for the next 5 years, we've been doing some data mining here at the Times of India to take a look at the turnout numbers and try and find some patterns among the key states to see what we should be watching out as the results trickle in. With us is Rishabh Srivastav, who's been doing the data mining, and Sanjeev Singh, senior journalist with the Times of India. Sanjeev and Rishabh, this is a map of the turnout delta. Turnout delta is the difference in voting turnout between 2014 and 2019. Rishabh, what does this map tell us and what should our viewers watch out for as they see the results coming in?
So in this map, Nalin, shades of green mean that turnout has increased and shades of red mean that turnout has decreased. Now, dark green means that turnout has increased more and dark red means that turnout has decreased a lot more.
So the deepest green that you're seeing here, this is where turnout has increased more than 5%. The light greens are turnout has increased between 3 to 5%. And the red, the deepest red, is where turnout has decreased by over 5%. So what we can see here, Rishabh, is that Madhya Pradesh has seen the biggest increase in turnout and parts of Rajasthan. If you can take us through these, what should we be watching out as we see the results coming in on our mobile phones and our screens?
So Madhya Pradesh in particular, Nalin, turnout has increased by a huge margin. Apart from Chhindwara, where it has increased by a relatively paltry 3%.
Chhindwara, of course, is the constituency of sitting Chief Minister Kamalnath.
And his son Nakulnath is contesting this year. But in a place like, say, Khajuraho, turnout has increased by 17%. In most of Madhya Pradesh, turnout has increased by double-digit numbers. Mm. Now, these numbers are fairly unprecedented. And it'll be interesting to see whether Congress or the BJP benefits from this. The exit polls are giving BJP a clean sweep in the state of Madhya Pradesh, but these turnout numbers do indicate that something strange is afoot in the state of Madhya Pradesh.
Sanjeev, we see deep greens in Madhya Pradesh, so huge turnout numbers increase here, but also in pockets of Rajasthan. Now, these are both states the Congress won just a few months ago in December. So what do you make of this increased turnout? In Rajasthan, for example, it's right up here from Jodhpur, right down to Chittorgarh.
I think, as Rishabh said, Madhya Pradesh is a state to watch out for because the results here are likely to be totally different from what we are expecting so far.
That's your assessment. Well, the exit polls are saying complete clean sweep for the BJP with virtually nothing for the Congress, according to the poll of polls in the exit poll. But you think that something special is happening here, and you know we'll have to wait and see whether it's the BJP voter which has come out or is the Congress voter which has got mobilized. Yeah, I mean, that's a big question.
Both parties are saying that, you know, their voters have come out more. But the logic that I am using is that in 2014, there was such a wave for Narendra Modi that there has to be something specially or something very different from 2014 for the voters to come out in
even
such
more
large
voters
numbers.
To come yes. Out. The BJP, of course, will say that yeah. The brand Modi has got strengthened and more our voters and more voters are shifting to our side.
Similarly for Rajasthan, if you see that these are the regions where BJP had done well even in the assembly elections. Hmm. So what is it that is making the voters come out in such large numbers, especially at a place where BJP had already done well?
So we've looked at Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. What's interesting to me is the key big state is UP. 80 seats, it will decide. I think all the exit polls agree in the direction that NDA will be forming the government. The question is, if they're absolutely right, will it be an NDA government or more predominantly a BJP government? If the trend line holds up. Now, what's looking to me interesting in UP is where also the exit polls have also, while the exit poll mean number is somewhere around 48 seats for BJP, there's a huge fluctuation between different polls. Look at the map of UP. Western UP has had lesser increases in turnout. In fact, these parts over here have had a decrease in turnout. And as you go eastward across UP, the turnout begins to increase. And it actually has increased a fair bit in the extreme eastern, in the Purvanchal regions. What do you make of this, Rishabh?
Now, in Western UP, Nalin, particularly in the areas of Kerana and Saharanpur, it is looking dicey for the BJP because in Kerala in particular, turnout fell by more than 5%. BJP replaced the late Hukum Singh's daughter, Mriganka Singh, with a new candidate this time round. And again, the Gujjar community in particular, a lot of them lost some of their enthusiasm because of that decision in Saharanpur as well. And these are all areas where, from what we have seen, farmers are coming out in record numbers. the Muslim community is coming out in record numbers. And given that, but the fact that overall turnout has decreased, Western UP does seem to spell trouble for the BJP. But Eastern UP, on the other hand, the BJP seems to have mobilized the vote a lot better. At the same time, as the phases went on, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had a flurry of rallies in this area. Mm. So we might actually see the BJP...
That galvanized the cadre and the voter. Because if you remember the phases, Sanjeev, phases 1 to 7 across UP were almost geographically divided from west to east. And you think the BJP has got better through the phases?
Well, right now we'll know whether it's got better, but the sense that one got from people who had gone on the ground in phase 6 and 7, there was this thing that, will the caste arithmetic, work to SP-BSP's advantage? What we're hearing is that maybe in the 6th and 7th phase, the vote transfer between SP-BSP has been very good. Mm. And that could also be a reason why we're seeing that the voter turnout has increased in the 6th and 7th phases.
So we'll wait and see what the final tally says. But at the moment, we're all speculating, trying to find a pattern from the turnout numbers and trying to square with what we are seeing in the exit poll numbers on that. The other key state to watch out, apart from UP and the Hindi heartland, of course, is West Bengal, the area where the BJP juggernaut has muscled its way into Mamata Banerjee's citadel in West Bengal. And what's interesting is that it's been the most vociferous, high-pitched, violent battle for votes. And look at this state of West Bengal, not that much enthusiasm for voting. West Bengal has not had a very high increase in voting. In fact, in this part over here, in the southeast of the state, it's actually gone down. But Rishabh, West Bengal also had a higher than average voting percentage last time as well, right?
Right. So West Bengal has one of the highest turnouts in India historically. Even this time around, West Bengal had north of 80% turnout.
Mm, which is huge, much higher compared to the rest of India, which is around late 60s, 67%.
Yeah. Absolutely. But given that, like in particular, if you look at these areas, turnout increased very, very mildly here. Mm. And what this means is that for the BJP to really get the kind of votes it's hoping to get, it'll have to convert existing Congress and CPM cadres to BJP supporting forces. Now, from what we've been hearing on the ground, it has been at least partly successful in doing so. And again, for the kind of exit poll numbers that we're seeing, if the BJP does indeed get 12 to 21 seats in the state of West Bengal, it would have to mean that they have been able to convert much of the cadres of the left into BJP supporters.
Nalin, that trend you can even see in Odisha. Mm. You know, that the polling percentage actually hasn't been that high as it was in 2014. Mm. It's gone down a bit. So I think adding to what Rishabh is saying, if we had seen large portions of green in both these states, then you could have said that, the voter turnout has increased and BJP is gaining. But now for the BJP to gain in both West Bengal and Odisha, it would simply mean that the left cadre or the BJD and Congress vote in Odisha has shifted towards the BJP. Only that perhaps would explain a big win for BJP in these two states.
Yeah, and also we know that a lot of the BJP's candidates in West Bengal have switched over from the TMC. We know that in Odisha, for example, its charge is led by Jay Panda, who also switched from the BJD. So there is a fair amount of transfer happening. The question is to what extent. Well, the turnout numbers are telling us that more voters have not come into the fray compared to 2014. It's going to be how many of them stick with the previous choices and how many switch over. Primarily, it's about that.
Absolutely.
Historically, it has always been argued, or the conventional wisdom has been, if it is high turnout change, then it translates into anti-incumbency against the ruling party. But scientifically, when we look at previous elections, I think that's a misnomer. It's never been proven. High changes in turnout can translate into a pro-incumbency vote as well as an anti-incumbency vote. Statistically, there is no evidence to show one over the other. So these changes, what's something special happening in Madhya Pradesh, parts of Rajasthan, here in Himachal, and maybe here in South Chhattisgarh, this is the area of Bastar. We'll wait and see when the results come in to see what the correlation is. And we'll, of course, keep bringing you the latest updates, the latest tally, and the perspective on what that means for whoever is forming the next government of India for the next 5 years. Keep watching The Times of India.